In this video demonstration, we're going to be looking at implementing remote desktop services. We'll begin by installing the remote desktop session host. We'll then look at configuring remote apps. And finally, we'll look at installing and configuring the remote desktop connection broker. So we'll begin by installing the remote desktop session host on NYC Server 4. I'm going to go into roles. I'm going to choose to add roles. Okay, now again, in an attempt to save time, these steps have already been completed on the second server. So we're going to our remote desktop services, we want the remote desktop session host, and we're going to select next. You want to require network level authentication. We're going to configure the licensing mode later. And for user groups, we're going to click on add. And under user groups, we're going to type in IT and production. Check names, OK, and next. For the client experience, I want to enable audio and video playback and desktop composition. From there, we'll click install. Now, the server needs to be restarted, so we'll go ahead and restart now. It's now back up and running, so let's go into administrative tools. And let's go into our remote desktop services and our remote desktop session host configuration. Now what I want to do here is I want to go into the properties of RDP TCP. From here, I'm going to click on sessions and I want to override user settings and limit an idle session to 15 minutes. I'm going to click on client settings. I want to limit the color resolution to 16 bits. And OK. From here, I'm going to go into the properties of remote desktop licensing, and for now, I'm just going to choose per device. I want to delete temporary folders on exit, and I want to restrict each user to a single logon. On server 5, let's go into control panel. And from here, we're going to go into programs, and we want to choose to install applications on the remote desktop. This opens up the new console. So from here, we are going to open, and I'm going to choose a file. It's not such a great file. I'm going to choose a PowerPoint viewer. So we're just going to move this to programs.exe. We're going to choose the PowerPoint viewer. And next. We accept the end user license agreement and continue. And once that's installed, we'll finish our wizard. Okay, so we're going to go into administrative tools, remote desktop services, and we want to go into the remote app manager. Now from here, we're going to add a couple of apps. So we're going to add a remote app. And then we're going to go down and we're going to select the Microsoft Office PowerPoint viewer. We are going to choose to not allow this program to be available through RD Web Access. And then just next through the wizard. Okay, so that's now done. Let's scroll down and we can see that PowerPoint viewer is available. So what I want to do is I want to create a Windows installer file, an MSI. So I'm going to click next, next, and I want to associate the client extensions with this remote app program. So we'll say finish, and you can see that it's created a PowerPoint Viewer MSI file. Now that's not the only way that we can do it. We can also create RDPs, and we'll look at that in a moment. Before we do that, let's just add another remote app package. Let's add calculator. I'm going to go into the properties and under user assignments, I only want this to be available for members of the production group. So I'm going to add my users and groups, type in production. And then from there, OK and OK. We hit next and finish. So I've now got two programs available to me. I'm going to create an RDP file. And create an RDP file for my PowerPoint viewer. So you now can see that I've got two ways that I can access this, either an MSI or RDP. Let's go on to our client machine and test these out. So the first one that I want to do is I want to connect up to the UNC path, so nyc-server5 $C. And then from there I'm going to go into Program Files, Package Programs, and I want to click on the PowerPoint Viewer MSI. So I'm going to right click and install. Also then want to copy the PowerPoint Viewer RDP file, and I'm just going to paste that on the desktop. So again, we see we've got two options. I can either install a file or have a link to an RDP file. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into Remote Programs and click on PowerPoint Viewer. Okay, it's moaning about the certificate, but we'll connect up anyway. I'm going to type in the username Andrea and the password password. And we're going to click OK. Now what this will do is it will connect up to the TS Remote App Server, and it's installed the program. And you can see it's now running like a native program on the client machine. If I scroll down to the client hard disk, so E on my client, I can select files on my local machine, which are then displayed in the remote app, as you can see in this PowerPoint example. So let's cancel out of this. Let's now try it using the RDP file. So if I double click, I'm going to connect up as Contoso Andrea. Now this hasn't installed anything on our machine. This is just purely connecting up to the remote app. And you can see that it works just like before. So there are your options. Now if I go back into my TS remote app, I'm going to go into Calculator and create an RDP file for this. Let's say next, finish, and again we will copy this file and paste it onto our client machine. So let's copy our Calc RDP, and paste it onto our machine. Now, if you remember rightly, Calculator was only available to certain users. Angie is a member of the production department. So if we connect up, we can see that the calculator opens. Again, looks like it's running like a native app. Back into server 4 then, let's go into server manager. We're going to go into roles, remote desktop services. And what I want to do is I want to add additional role services. Now what I want to do is I want to add the remote desktop connection broker. Now this is going to effectively set up some load balancing against multiple machines for me. So I'm going to go into configuration, I'm going to go into local users and groups, and under groups I want to click on my session broker computers, I'm going to click on add. Under my object types I'm going to select computer, and then from there I'm going to type in my computer name. So I'm going to type in NYC server 4 and then NYC server 5. So I've got my two machines that are going to be in the broker group. Okay, so on server 4, let's go into remote desktop services and let's go into our session host configuration. Let's scroll down and we're going to change the properties of the member of. And just bear in mind that I've had to do this on both machines, but I'm only showing you it on one as to save time. So I'm going to farm member and we're going to type in the connection broker server name, and this is going to be NYC server 4. Contoso.com. And my farm name I'm going to type in as Contoso RDS. So Contoso RDS. We're going to participate in connection broker load balancing, and I'm going to select the IP address to use in the connection. From here then, let's go into remote desktop services, remote app manager. I'm going to change the properties of one of my remote apps. So I'm going to add a remote app. And I'm going to select calculator. And under properties, under user assignments, again, I'm going to make this available just to production. And we'll say OK and next. I scroll down, we've got calculator. I'm going to create an RDP file. but I want to change the server. And instead of pointing to NYC server 4, what I want to point to is I want to point to Contoso RDS. So it's pointing to effectively this cluster group. I'm saying next and finish. And we see that we've got calc RDP. So let's go into NYC DC1, because what we're going to need to do here is we're going to need to make other computers aware of the Contoso RDS. So I need to go into DNS, I need to go into my forward lookup zone of Contoso, and I need to add a new A record. For my name, it's going to be Contoso RDS. And my IP address is going to be 10.10.0.24. And I now need to do it again for my second server, so Contoso RDS. The IP address 10.10.0, and this time 25. So we're at our host. Back into our client machine, then let's just clean up our desktop so we get rid of those two RDP files. And we're going to connect up and pull across this effectively clustered one. So I'm going to go to the NYC server 4C dollar. Under program files, package programs, calc.rdp. Then let's copy that and paste it onto our client desktop. From here we'll connect. And we're going to connect up as Andrea. Type in the password. Now what you'll notice is I've got two certificate errors because I'm effectively connecting to two machines. So it just goes to prove that the broker service is indeed working.